In 32 years of marriage and thousands of hours of coaching couples, I have found one marriage tip most couples don't know, and once they learn it, it drastically changes their marriage. Join me and I'll share it with you. I'm Julia Woods, coach, trainer, and founder of Beautiful Outcome, a coaching company committed to helping couples communicate so you can partner in creating your dream life and marriage. If you want to grow your connection in your marriage, I have a free gift for you that I'll tell you more about at the end. When my husband and I got married 32 years ago, we had the 10 rules for a happy marriage. We thought we were all set. Here's what those 10 rules were. 1, never both be angry at the same time. 2, never yell at each other unless the house is on fire. 3, if one of you has to win an argument, let it be your spouse. 4, if you have to criticize, do it lovingly. 5, never bring up mistakes from the past. 6, neglect the whole world rather than each other. 7, never go to sleep with an argument unsettled. 8, at least once a day, say a kind word or pay a compliment to your partner. 9, when you have done something wrong, admit it and ask for forgiveness. And 10, it takes 2 to make a quarrel, and the one in the wrong is usually the one who does the most talking. We thought we were set. They seemed simple enough when we were first married, and life was pretty smooth sailing. And then give it a few years of running a business together and raising kids, and these rules seemed nearly impossible. I interpreted these rules to mean we weren't supposed to have conflict. We weren't supposed to be angry, yell, or leave arguments unsettled. To me, that clearly meant conflict is bad. Tension is a sign we aren't happy. And all that did was cause more tension in our marriage. So we decided it was better to act like the tension or the conflict didn't exist. So then we just started letting it brew underneath the surface. This is the biggest mistake we were making while we were trying to do it the right way. The biggest, and I believe the number one tip for every marriage, is that tension is what produces growth. Tension is a beautiful thing. A plant needs sun, water, and nutrients. But what actually produces the growth is the root breaking through an obstacle in the soil. This is the same as marriage. Marriage needs love, commitment, and connection. And what produces growth is breaking through the tension together, breaking through obstacles. Tension comes when we see things differently, want different things, have different approaches. This can trigger our individual fears, doubts, insecurities, and limiting beliefs. When you can work together to uncover those things, you can face your fears, work through your doubts, heal your insecurities, and rewrite your limiting beliefs together. This is nature's way of growing you as individuals and as a couple. It is the greatest gift of marriage when two people bring out the best in each other by breaking through obstacles or tension together. Is it easy? It can get easier and easier, and the more you develop your ability to break through tension together, the easier it gets. Tension begins to become a normal thing, just like hunger pains. You don't get stressed when you're hungry. You just get something to eat. Imagine if tension in your marriage could be the same. You don't get stressed about it. You just work through it. When you do that, you and your marriage will get stronger and stronger. Now, I mentioned a free gift I have waiting for you, and it is my ebook called Turn Defensiveness into Connection. And it is available for you if you click the link underneath this video. Would you please like and subscribe to this video and let me know if you want to learn to grow through tension in your marriage in the comment section below. I look forward to seeing you next week. Hey, hon.
Yeah.
Which of those 10 rules for a happy marriage most stuck out to you when we first got married?
Don't go to bed angry.
It actually was don't go to bed with an argument unsettled.
To me, that's the same thing.
Yeah, that one stuck out to me a lot.